Because only the present moment contains life. The past is no longer there. The future is not yet there. Only the present moment has life in it. So when I breathe in and take refuge, my in-breath, I touch life deeply. When I take a step and I take refuge entirely in my step, I touch life deeply. And by doing that, I stop running. Stopping running is a very important practice. Because we have been running all our life, we believe that peace, happiness, success are there. We don't know that everything should be looked for in the here and the now. Peace, happiness, stability. I have arrived means I have arrived in the here and the now. The address of life. Here, now. Here now, herenow.com. Life is available only in the here and the now. God is available only in the here and the now. And that is why it's very important to go home to the here and the now. And you have wonderful means to go home to the here and the now. And that is why we have to learn how to take refuge in our in-breath. Because with one in-breath, you can arrive in the here and the now. And stop all the running. And with a step, you arrive in the here and the now and touch God, touch the ultimate, touch peace in yourself, restore peace in yourself. There's a seed of peace and joy within yourself. And if you know how to take refuge in your in-breath, in your step, you can touch the seed of peace and joy in yourself and make them manifest for your enjoyment. So instead of taking refuge in a notion, in a vague notion, abstract notion, God, Buddha, Allah, we want to take refuge in the reality of the ultimate. And God can be touched in your in-breath, can be touched in your step. And many of us have succeeded in doing so. We enjoy living deeply every moment of our daily life by the practice of touching the ultimate, touching joy and peace in the here and the now. It sounds easy. Everyone can do it, but it takes some training. Because if you are used to run all your life, it has become a habit of running, running to seek for something. So the practice of stopping is a very crucial. Stopping. And you stop by what? You stop by means of your in-breath, by means of your out-breath. You stop by means of your making steps. And that is why the basic practice in Plum Village is the practice of mindful breathing, mindful walking. And if you master this practice, and then you can practice mindful eating, mindful drinking, mindful cooking, mindful driving. And you are always with God. You are always with the ultimate. You are always with life. You are always with peace and happiness. Don't do like that teacher and his students. Always running until they see a funeral. and realize that this is the ultimate, that is final picnic. Should not do like them. We have to enjoy our picnic right here and right now, and you have the instruments of enjoying your picnic right here and right now, to enjoy your in-breath, to enjoy your steps. And if you think that it's very difficult to make an in-breath, you are wrong. It's very difficult to make a step in mindfulness, you are wrong, because they are highly enjoyable. Because you can touch peace by just by breathing in. You can get in touch with peace while you make a step. You touch the seat of peace inside of us. And you remove the tension in your body, in your feelings. You remove the conflict within your feelings, your perceptions, by breathing like that, by sitting like that, by walking like that, by eating like that. The practice is the practice of mindfulness. Mindfulness of breathing, mindfulness of walking, mindfulness of eating, mindfulness of dishwashing, mindfulness of cooking, always dwelling in the here and the now, and not allow yourself to be pulled away by the future, by your worries about the future, your projects about the future, and your regrets about the past. We have to recover, to reclaim our freedom. Because we have lost our freedom. We are caught by our past. We are caught by our worries concerning the future. We don't have the capacity to be here and be now and not touch life. And that is why it's very important to learn the art of being peace in the here and the now, and with the presence of a community of practice, this becomes very easy. On your left, there is a friend who knows how to breathe in and out and touch the present moment. In your right, there is another friend who knows how to make a step and dwell peacefully and happy in the present moment. Behind you, there is a sister who can do like that. In front of you, there is a brother who can do like that. You are surrounded by people who know the art of living in the present moment, stopping the running and touching the seat of peace and joy that are in every one of us, and become an instrument for peace, of peace for people around us. I have arrived. This is a practice and not a statement, not a declaration. I have arrived. I have arrived in the here and the now. And I am in a situation where I can touch life deeply with all the wonders. The rain is a wonder. The sunshine is a wonder. The trees are a wonder. The face of children are wonders. And there are so many wonders of life around us. There are so many wonders of life inside of us. Your eyes is a wonder. You need to open them and then you can see all kinds of colors and forms. Your heart is a wonder. If your heart stops functioning, and then nothing can continue. And that is why when you go home to the present moment, you touch the wonders of life that are inside of us and around us, and you just enjoy. You don't have to wait for tomorrow in order to have peace and joy. I have arrived. This is a practice. And when you breathe in, you say that I have arrived. And whether you have arrived or not, you know. Whether you are still running, you know. Even if you are sitting quietly like this, but you are still running. Running in your mind.